pancreatitis is inflammation of the pancreas, which can be a short-term or chronic problem. In this video, we will discuss the functions of the pancreas, list symptoms and ways to diagnose pancreatitis, and differentiate between acute and chronic pancreatitis. The pancreas is an organ in the abdomen. It is connected to other organs such as the stomach, gallbladder, and small intestines, and is critical for digestion. The pancreas is the main organ where digestive enzymes are produced to digest carbohydrates, fats, and protein. It also produces hormones such as insulin and glucagon to regulate blood sugar levels. While the exact mechanism causing pancreatitis is not fully understood, it is believed that enzymes in the pancreas are activated within the organ. These active enzymes digest the pancreatic cells, leading to inflammation and eventual destruction of the cells. In turn, the enzymes do not reach the small intestine, resulting in food that cannot be digested. The most common symptom of pancreatitis is upper abdominal pain. In fact, pain is the overriding symptom for 85 to 90% of people with chronic pancreatitis. This pain can be constant or occur in week-long episodes and is often associated with nausea and vomiting. For many people, it spreads to the back and worsens after eating or drinking, potentially causing them to fear eating and drinking, resulting in weight loss. Other symptoms of chronic pancreatitis can include chronic unexplained weight loss that is not related to changes in eating habits, diarrhea, oily stools, and clay-colored stools. As mentioned at the beginning of this video, there are two types of pancreatitis. Acute pancreatitis is a sudden but normally short-lived inflammation, whereas chronic pancreatitis is the result of irreversible damage to the pancreas that is caused by repeated or prolonged inflammation. There are some differences in symptoms and complications between these two. Acute pancreatitis is the most common form of the condition and often subsides after a few days with treatment. However, sometimes it can lead to severe complications. In severe acute pancreatitis, parts of the pancreas may die and body fluid may escape into the abdominal cavity, resulting in a decrease in blood volume and a large drop in blood pressure, possibly causing shock and organ failure. Severe acute pancreatitis can be life-threatening, with approximately 3 to 4% dying from it. There are many potential causes of acute pancreatitis, with alcohol abuse and gallstones being the most common. Some of the other causes include smoking, elevated triglycerides, certain medications, and injury or trauma to the pancreas. Other health problems like infections, cystic fibrosis, and kidney failure can also lead to pancreatitis. Chronic pancreatitis develops slowly over time. Long-term heavy alcohol consumption is the most common cause of chronic pancreatitis. Long-term smoking is also a prevalent risk factor. Obviously, eliminating these lifestyle risk factors is part of the treatment for pancreatitis, although very often the person will be unable to give these up due to their addiction. Other notable causes of pancreatitis include cystic fibrosis, gallstones, and high triglycerides. Malnutrition and weight loss are almost always prevalent in those with chronic pancreatitis due to the body's inability to digest food properly. The malabsorption of nutrients can lead to vitamin and mineral deficiencies and their related problems. Chronic pancreatitis can also lead to serious complications such as diabetes and calcification of the pancreas, which may require surgery. Other problems related to metabolic stress can occur, such as edema, hyperglycemia, and sepsis that can result in multi-organ failure and death. The risk for pancreatic cancer is also higher in those with chronic pancreatitis. Chronic pancreatitis is easily misdiagnosed as acute because the symptoms are similar. However, there are a number of tests that help diagnose chronic pancreatitis, including blood to look for abnormal levels of pancreatic enzymes and blood sugar response. Imaging tests such as x-rays, CT scans, MRI, and ultrasounds can also be used to help diagnose pancreatitis. A secretin stimulation test, which measures how the pancreas functions during digestion, may also be used. As you consider the symptoms and complications of pancreatitis presented in this video, you should be thinking forward to identify how nutrition will be used to treat it.